the University of Lagos anthem. Thank you. Please be seated. We have gathered here today to celebrate one who has served within the academic community meritoriously. One who has left her mark in the sands of time and imprinted her values in the hearts of students and members of the community. And so I'd like to recognize the distinguished guests that are here seated who have come to honor this occasion. I'd like to start by recognizing the Vice Chancellor of the University of Lagos, Professor Folashade Ogunshola, FZSN, who is ably represented by Professor Ayodele Asenua, the Deputy Vice Chancellor, Development Services. Welcome, ma'am. I'd like also to recognize the presence of the Deputy Vice Chancellor, Management Services, Professor Lucien Ochukwu. You're welcome, sir. I want to also recognize here with us the representative of the acting registrar of the University of Lagos, Mr. Obafemi Keshinro. You're welcome, sir. I want to recognize the presence of the former Deputy Vice Chancellor, Academic and Research, Professor Oluwole Familoni. You're welcome, sir. Also, in that manner, I'd like to recognize Professor Kayode Almond, who is also here with us, former Vice Chancellor of Elizade University. You're welcome, sir. I'd like to recognize the Dean of the Faculty of Science, the faculty that is hosting this program, Professor Elijah Oyeyemi. You're welcome, sir. I would also not fail to recognize the Dean of Environmental Science, Professor M.M. Omiri. You're welcome, ma. We did not miss the distinguished academics, so I would not be able to recognize every single one of us. Please don't be offended. But we would try to recognize as many as possible as the program continues. But before I move on, I'd like to recognize Professor Ashekun, the head of department of the chemistry. You're welcome, ma. Also want to recognize one whom we refer to as a golden professor, Professor J. Olalero. You're welcome, sir. I want to specially recognize someone who is also part of the occasion today. I want to recognize the husband to Professor Egonmwan, Sir Andy Egonmwan. I will take the remaining the recognitions as we progress. So we move on to a welcome address that will be given by the head of department, the department that has brought every one of us together, the Department of Zoology. And I warmly welcome forward Professor E.T. Idowu for the welcome address. HOD, sir. Please, let's give him a round of applause as he comes.
The Vice Chancellor, Professor Fola Shadi Okunshola, able represented in this occasion by our DVC, Development Services, Professor Ayodele Atenua. DVC Management Service Professor Lucian Chuku, DVC Academics and Research Professor Bola Obo is unavailably absent. The Acting Registrar represented by Mrs. Olukunle Makinde, represented by Mr. Keshiro Obafemi. The Bursar, the University Librarian, the Dean of our Faculty, Faculty of Science, Professor Elijah Oyeyemi, directors and deans of faculties, head of departments, distinguished academic colleagues, distinguished non-teaching colleagues, administrative and technical, your lordship, spiritual and temporal, the chairman of this event, Dr. Bamidele Makonjola, and the guest speakers. Permit me, sorry for I didn't have your name here. Our dear students, gentlemen of the press, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. My welcome address at the retirement ceremony of Professor Princess Rosemary Egonmwan, I am honored and privileged to stand before you today to extend a warm and heartfelt welcome as we gather to celebrate the remarkable career and retirement of our esteemed colleague, Professor Princess Rosemary Iriowen Egonmwan. Throughout her illustrious career, Professor Egonmwan has exemplified the highest standard of excellence in academia, research, and service to our department, university, and nation. As a professor of environmental physiology of animals and conservation at the Department of Zoology, University of Lagos, her dedication and passion for her have left an indelible mark on the academic landscape. Professor Egonmwan tenure at the University of Lagos spanned over 4 decades, during which she served with distinction as assistant lecturer, rising through the ranks to become a full professor in 2007. Her contributions to teaching and research and mentorship have been unparalleled, as evidenced by her supervision of numerous BSc, MSc, and PhD candidates, totaling 140, 110 respectively. Beyond her academic duties, Professor Egonmwan has actively involved in service to the university, the nation, and beyond. She has served in various capacities within the Department of Zoology, including as course advisor, postgraduate coordinator, and head of department. Additionally, she has made significant contributions to the faculty and university at all levels, serving on committees and boards, including the School of Postgraduate Studies and the Senate. Professor Egonmwan's impact extends beyond academia, as she's also served the nation in numerous capacities, including a senior environmental advisor to Shell, and as an independent non-executive director in Vitafoam Nigerian PLC, where she later assumed the role of chairman of the board of directors. Her dedication to the field of zoology and conservation is further evidenced by her membership in professional societies, of her status as Fellow of Zoological Society of Nigeria and the Zoological Society of London. As we gather to celebrate Professor Egonmwan's distinguished career and bid her farewell as she embarks on the next chapter of her life, let us express our deepest gratitude for her invaluable contributions to our department, Department of Zoology, the academic community at large. Please join me to extend our warmest wishes to Professor Egonmwan for a fulfilling and joyful retirement, filled with same passion and enthusiasm that she defined her career thus far. Thank you all.
Thank you, head of department, Zoology. Next, to give a welcome address is the Dean of the Faculty of Science. Please, let's give a round of applause to Professor Elijah Oyeyemi as he comes forward.
Good morning, everyone. While I would have loved to stand by the established that is already, the protocol that's already established, I would like to recognize a few people. The protocol deserves that. The Vice Chancellor, who is ably represented by the DVC DS, Professor Asena, you are welcome. The Deputy Vice Chancellor, MS, Professor Lucia Chuku, you are welcome, sir. All other protocol duly observed. It's a great pleasure for me to be here today and to be part of this ceremony. This is actually not the right time to talk about Professor Egonmwan. When the time comes, I will say a little things I know about her. But I welcome you to this occasion. And it is, I believe, that at the end of the day, every one of us will be very happy that you really attended this occasion. It's a great thing for someone to be celebrated at this age. And with sound mind and very healthy. If you see Professor Egonmwan, you will never believe that she's already 70. Probably think that she's in her 60s. I thank every one of all for you for coming here to celebrate this occasion with us. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dean, Faculty of Science. Thank you for that remarks. I would now take this opportunity to welcome forward for the opening speech to be given by the Vice Chancellor of the University of Lagos, Professor Folashade Ogunshola, FASON, who is here represented by the Deputy Vice Chancellor, Development Services, Professor Ayodele Atsenua. Please, a round of applause for her as she comes forward. Please, let's keep clapping until she gets here.
Thank you very much. The chairman of today's occasion, Dr. Mark Ojuola, the honoree of today, Professor Rosemary Egonmwan, with her husband, Leonard Silk, Sir Egonmwan, S-A-N, members of the management of the University of Lagos here present, led by the Deputy Vice Chancellor, Management Services, the Dean, the Head of Department, and the Dean, our hosts. And of course, I must recognize distinguished faculty members of the University of Lagos, including the very retired ones and the recently retired ones on whose broad shoulders the rest of us start, which is the reason why there's still a University of Lagos. I recognize Professor Amond, I recognize Professor Akpata, and I recognize Professor Otubanjo. At least those three I have seen coming. The Vice Chancellor sends her warm greetings and her regret from being able to be here personally with some other members of management. That is because they have had to go to attend to some other official business outside of the university campus. But she has asked me to communicate her warm felicitations to the honoree of today, Professor Egonmwan. If there is a University of Lagos today that we call the nation's pride, it is because of the diligent service of people like Professor Egonmwan. There is no university. There is no university outside its faculty and its students. Its students are made by the faculty. Its students become the great alumni whose reputation lends to that of the university. And that is why at the University of Lagos, we value those who give their life and spend their all training, teaching, and researching, all of which bring reputation to the University of Lagos. We want to use this opportunity to say a very big thank you once again on behalf of the Senate of the University of Lagos and the entire University of Lagos, Professor Egonmwan, for all that you have done to add value to University of Lagos. Thank you. Thank you for helping to make zoology at the University of Lagos one of the flagship programs all over Nigeria. Thank you for taking the name of University of Lagos beyond the walls of Akoka and getting it out there as you served even in the private sector and you served even the international community. We wish you well in retirement. We ask that the Almighty God will renew you. Retired you may be, but you remain part of the community. Please always come back. Please lead us. Continue to send us messages. Continue to mentor us even from outside. Are there thoughts about research directions that you think we should be exploring? Please send a message to your mentees, first generation, second, and third, and say, why not explore this? Are there opportunities that you think, please send? And even in retirement, so that you can keep young, please continue to do research. Continue to join us as we do the research. And together, we will continue to make University of Lagos great and Nigeria better than it is. I thank you very much, and I welcome you all once again.
A round of applause again for the Vice Chancellor, Professor Folashade Ogunshola, ably represented by the Deputy Vice Chancellor Development Services, Professor Ayodele Asenua. Thank you for that opening speech. I quickly just recognize a few more persons, dignitaries who are here. Ought to have done this earlier. We have this occasion, a chairman of this occasion, and one who is also like a family to the department. I'd like to recognize Dr. Bamidele Omakanjola, the chairman of this occasion. Please, a round of applause for him. Thank you, sir. Also wants to recognize the General Managing Director of Vitafoam Nigeria PLC, Mr. Taiwo Adeni, who is ably represented by Mr. Shola Owade from Vitafoam. You're welcome, sir. Also want to recognize all the senior executive members of the Vitafoam group. You're all welcome. I'd like to recognize the presence of one of our guest speakers for today. It's one whom we trust will be bringing great insights into how we can apply zoology in contemporary times. And so I'd like to recognize Engineer Nedo Osayade, the chairman of Belema Oil Producing Limited. You're welcome, sir. Professor Alexander Ogumba is the second guest speaker. Not sure if he's probably would be joining us, or I'm not sure if he's online, but he'll be joining us. So he's from the Department of Zoology, University of Ibadan. Let me also recognize the director of DLI, Professor Uchenna Udiani. You're welcome, ma'am. Also recognize the wife of former Vice Chancellor, Mrs. Oluwaseun Ogundipe. You're welcome, ma'am. In our midst, like I said, there are lots of important persons, and we would recognize you as the program continues. So at this time, are we ready for the documentary? Okay. At this time, we will take a short, before the documentary, we will take the chairman's speech. We'll take the chairman's speech before we take the documentary. So I'd like to welcome Dr. Bamidele Makonjola to give his speech. Please, a round of applause.
Vice Chancellor, the Deputy Vice Chancellors, University Management Team, professors, and other lecturers, students, invited guests, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, and members of the press, you are all welcome. We are here this morning to celebrate an accomplished and celebrated lady. As a starter, I want to mention that I, for one, I'm one of our greatest admirers. I admire Mrs. Egonmwan. I've known her now for well over 40 years, and I cannot stop admiring her. So you asked me why. Number one, she's a renowned academician. She studied in Unilag with distinction, and she eventually got a PhD from one of the best universities in this world. I think when universities are rated every year, Oxford University is either number 3 or number 5 in the world. So you can imagine that she went there and she excelled. So there's a lot to admire in her. And I want to confirm to you too that she's not an academician. She's a corporate guru. I will tell you more. Now, she's a princess of Benin Kingdom. I think that's now, she's a mother in Israel. She has nurtured a fantastic family. And maybe I should have started with this. I think you agree with me. Ms. Egonmwan is a very beautiful woman. So you can see why I cannot stop admiring her. I know that so much will be said about our academic exploits, so I won't take your time on that. Maybe for the young ones here majorly, I have to say a bit about our exploits in the corporate world. Some 6 years ago, Mr. Egonmwan was invited to join the board of one of the leading companies in Nigeria. She served on the board, and she served creditably. She excelled in her corporate discharge to the point that when it was noticed that she was about to attain the age of 70, the organization decided that she must be honored, she must be appreciated to become the chairman of the board of the organization. The first woman to attain that, and one of the first women, and possibly she's among the very few women that have risen to become the chairman of any of the leading organizations in Nigeria. And I want to tell you that there was no regret. The 1 year she served on the board of Vitafoam, she took it to a very high level. You can't believe it, that the profitability of the company grew by, I think, over 14% within 1 year. So I want you to see that she's just not an academic. She's just not a scholar. But she's a businesswoman. She knows how to make money. So you can see that everything about her calls for our admiration. And you find out that she has even gone beyond that. She has raised a family that is admired all over. She brought up very nice, successful children. And you know what? I can still remember when I was still on the board serving with her. Whenever we got to some naughty issues, she will make a contribution, but she will not make the finance. You know what Ms. Egonmwan will say? She will say that, I will get back to the board in a few days' time. I want to consult my husband. And you can be sure she will get back to us. You know why she will say she wants to consult her husband? Because her husband is one of the leading bankers in Nigeria. The husband was already a director of one of the top three banks in Nigeria when somebody like me was still a middle level manager. So when she said that she was going to consult her husband, I understand, because her husband has experience more than all of us sitting down on the board of Vitafoam combined. So she said, I will consult my husband. And that says a lot about her. It shows that she's not an arrogant woman. She recognized that the husband has that experience, and she tapped into it. So I want us all here to learn from that. She has succeeded because she remained very humble. She remained humble. She didn't come to the board and arrogate herself. You know, some professors, they will come to the board and they will make other board members feel as if they never went to school. No. She served, she learned, and she contributed. So all this combined has made her a great woman. So I want to encourage those of us young ones here, and even some lecturers that are here that are still coming up. Please learn from her. She's a great role model. She has set a high mark for women now in Nigeria, that women should try to get to the height of their profession. She has gone to the height of her profession in academics. In corporate Nigeria, she has gone to the height of it. And culturally and socially, she belongs to one of the greatest kingdoms in Nigeria, and she's a princess there. So she has everything going for her. So please, I want to employ us all to stand up and give her a round of applause. So please be seated. So I thank you all. At this juncture, I want to give an apology that I will not be able to stay here long with you, because as of today, my immediate junior sister, she's 70 years old. And at this very moment, a service is being conducted for her. And as Olori Ebi, I have to be there. So please, will you permit me, I will hand over the chairmanship to Mr. Owade, Executive Director of VitaFood. Thank you very much.
Please, a round of applause once again to the chairman, Dr. Bamidele Makwajola. Those of you that might be wondering, Makwajola, if you know Professor Makwajola of the Department of Zoology, then that is her husband. All right, so we will... So because the chairman needs to leave very soon, we want to make a quick adjustment to the program. We have a presentation that will be made to the chairman. So please, can we have the gift so we can take that now before he leaves? So I want to invite the Dean of the Faculty of Science, Professor Elijah Oyemi, to help present this plaque to the chairman.
The Department of Zoology, University of Lagos, present this award to Dr. Bamidele Oswolale Makanjuola, Chairman of the Valedictory Program, in honor of Professor Princess Rosemary Iriowen Egonmwan, held on 16th April 2024, signed by the head of the Department of Zoology, Professor E.T. Idowu, and the chair local organizing committee, Professor K.A. Kemabunta. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you. Now we would move on to the documentary. We have a short documentary.
In the heart of Nigeria's bustling city of Lagos, a remarkable scholar dedicated her life to the pursuit of knowledge and the empowerment of the generation. This is the story of Professor Aro I. Egonmwan. a beacon of wisdom and inspiration. As we explore our illustrious journey at the University of Lagos and the profound impact she made, culminating in her retirement on March 10, 2024. Professor Iriowen Rosemary Egonmwan, born on March 28, 1954, in Benin City, hails from the royal household of His Royal Majesty Uku Akpolokolo, Oba Akenzua II, the Oba of Benin. She had a unique upbringing as the daughter of Princess Oluabo, the late second daughter of the Oba of Benin. Unfortunately, she lost her mother at the tender age of 4 and was brought to live permanently in the palace by her grandparents, the Oba of the Olori of Benin, until her marriage in 1976. In her early academic years, Professor Iriowen attended Ogbe Baptist Primary School in Benin City, which was conveniently located near the palace. After graduating from primary school, she proceeded to St. Maria Goretti Catholic Girls' School in Benin City, where she excelled in her studies and obtained an A division in her West African Examination Council exams. Recognizing her academic potential, her aunt, Princess Tokumbo, who lived in Lagos, encouraged her grandparents to allow her to pursue her passion for science in Lagos. Her journey into academics was initially inspired by her natural curiosity and later by interaction with successful individuals. She took the common entrance exam to secondary school and attended the same school where her older sisters and aunties had studied, so she had no reason to fear being bullied. As a young girl, she had loved for reading and enjoyed books such as Moons and Booms. She also engaged in activities like knitting and baking, and in her leisure time, she could often be seen reading magazine.
My name is Rosemary Iriowen Egon, a professor of zoology in the University of Lagos.
During her undergraduate years, she displayed a strong aptitude for the sciences, but her passion for medicine was not as strong. Fortunately, her parents did not pressure her into pursuing medicine, allowing her to follow her true passion for zoology and her love for animals. Professor Iriowen's academic excellence at the University of Lagos, Unilag, can be attributed to her consistent hard work and active participation in lectures and lab work. Education in those days was rigorous, with long hours spent in class, practical section, and extensive library studies. Her education earned her the name Bookworm among her colleagues. She would often retire late to the hostel for dinner and spend time chatting with her roommates, including Professor Edith Elumoha, who later became a professor at the University of Port Harcourt. Her first academic award was received during her primary school years when she was awarded a €150 scholarship for achieving the best result in the Midwest region of Nigeria. In Unilag, she received an award that supported her from her first year to her final year, enabling her to graduate and also secure a position as an academic staff member at the university.
How did you come by the name Rosemary? I've always had my Benin name, which is Iriowen. Rose was a nickname given to me by my aunt. She's late now.
During her master's degree, she received a scholarship that took her to the University of Oxford, where she pursued her studies in zoology. Her career in zoology was greatly influenced by outstanding lecturers such as Professor Victor Yoloye, who made the subject engaging and simple. Professor Yoloye became a mentor and supervised her research on aquatic molluscs during her master's degree. Other influential lecturers include Professor Kusemuji Odiete Malaka and the late Professor Don Pedro, whose teachings deepened her interest and inspired her to pursue an academic career. Professor Iriowen's advice to young colleagues as she retires after 48 years in the academia is to view it as an interesting and noble career. She encourages them to invest in self-development, continuous learning, and to take advantage of the opportunities offered by the internet age. She warns against the temptation to leave the country, referred to as Japa syndrome, and encourages young colleagues to aspire to be the best in their field and contribute their talents to national development.
I did my PhD in Oxford. right from the entrance to the Department of Zoology, everything that you need is there. There was no problem with doing my research in Oxford. The challenges were there.
Throughout her career, Professor Iriowen faced challenges such as acquiring research materials and obtaining samples for her PhD, which required her husband to transport them from Nigeria to Oxford. However, she overcame these challenges and achieved success in her academic pursuit. As she bid farewell to university, Professor Iriowen expressed her gratitude to her PhD supervisors and mentor, Professor Sarah Randolph, who supervised her PhD and even helped care for her first child during that time. She also extended her appreciation to her students, who has now become esteemed colleagues, and acknowledged the support of Professor Imokpai, who provides a mobile day care and cared for her first child when she resumed her position at Unilag. Additionally, she expressed gratitude to Professor Odiete, Yoloye, Malaka, Kusumeji, and others who mentored her throughout her career. Finally, she thanks Professor Alo, Professor Ogundipe, Professor Bola Obo, Professor Almond, Professor Joy Okusu, Professor Olasumbo Abuaba, Professor Dele Oluwo Kudejo, and Deputy Vice Chancellor Management Service, Professor Atensua, for the wonderful time shared in the University of Lagos.
It's not easy to give 4 decades of one's life to one cause. She has given almost 5 decades of her life to the University of Lagos. And so I think she deserves another round of applause. We will be moving on to the first lecture for today. The first lecture for this morning. And this is a lecture that will be given by Engineer Nedo Osayade. And so I'd like to please call him forward even as we take his citation. Please, a round of applause for him. Engineer Nedo Osayade is the chairman, Belema Oil Producing Nigeria Limited. So I will be reading his citation for us. Nedo Osayade is an executive in the oil and gas industry with over 40 years of diverse local and international experience in leading and managing multicultural teams, mostly in Shell, Nigeria, and Netherlands, Adole Machapchi in the Netherlands. He has attended leadership education at the Wharton Business School, a fellow of the Nigerian Association of Petroleum Explorationists. He was previously Shell Nigeria's Geosolution Manager, and as well as a General Manager, Sustainable Development and Community Relations. He was also Shell Nigeria's Head Technology R&D. He championed the creation of the leading Shell Center of Excellence for Geosciences and Petroleum Engineering at the University of Benin City, where he was endowed a prize for the best graduating master degree student. He is currently the chairman of Belema Oil Producing Limited, as well as external facilitator at the University of Lagos Business School. With diverse business interests, he is the CEO of Lekosa Nigeria Limited. I present to you Mr. Nedo Osayade.
Mr. Chairman, it's just worked out. The Vice Chancellor, Professor Fola Shade, ably represented by Professor Asenua, Deputy Vice Chancellor Lucian Chuku, the honoree for this occasion, Sir Egonmwan, the husband, all professors in this gathering, distinguished members of the university community, ladies and gentlemen. Let me first of all make some correction. I am not an engineer. I'm just a scientist. My background is physics. And what I'm going to be talking about has little to do with zoology or biology. The limit of my biology is with Stone and Cousins in secondary school. So I was told that I am free to select whatever topic I so like to talk about. So I elected to talk about how Nigeria should be preparing for the impending disruption that will be brought about by artificial intelligence. I doubt if you can see that slide very well. What next slide?
Sure.
Yeah. Okay, good. I'm going to be speeding through my number of slides, and I'll be covering, in general, what's artificial intelligence, what possibilities does it bring about, what kind of disruptions do we expect, some criticism of artificial intelligence, some Nigerian businesses that are rapidly embracing AI, artificial intelligence, the fact that artificial intelligence comes with some risks, and therefore some legislation is being put to try to guard against the shortcomings of AI, and there's a great fear about whether AI can overtake humanity. And so the question has been asked whether AI should be stopped. And I'll be posing some comments about why it cannot be stopped, in spite of whatever negative sides that may come with the good positives that we expect it to have. And finally, my last two slides, the meat of the matter, some ideas about how Nigeria can prepare for the disruption that will come. It is not a matter of whether it may come, but certainly it will. What is artificial intelligence? It's the simulation of human intelligence in machines to copy, to mimic the brain functions of human beings, such as in learning, solving problems, perception, and decision making. So in the main, AI learns from vast amounts of data, and without us specifically programming for different possibilities, it's able to adjust by itself and learn and do the things without such specific programming. It's applied across various fields, whether it's in warfare, healthcare, finance, transportation. Indeed, there's hardly any facet of life that AI will not affect. So in the main, we will have to live, work, and play in the world that AI will be defining. And of course, there will be some economic concerns I will touch on as well. Some criticism of AI. It's ironical that from the name, artificial intelligence, the first criticism of it is that it is not intelligent. So it begins to sound like an oxymoron. You say it's artificial intelligence, and yet you say it is not intelligent. In the main, because it's been argued that it relies on what we call old knowledge. For those who use ChatGPT, for example, one of the most popular of the AI series right now, there's a caveat that whatever information it gives you reaches a maximum in the year 2021. And so whatever other knowledge we have acquired as Homo sapiens from 2021 to date may not be there. So if it were intelligent, it should have been self-updating at the moment. That's it. That's some old thinking. It is based, and if you give it a wrong set of data to learn from, or a biased set of data to learn from, then the output you get will be biased as well. It's argued that it cannot bring in intuition and judgment to making decisions. And like I said before, a big risk is that it may someday challenge human beings. Now, we know that in recent times, OpenAI and Google have created models that already possess genuine intelligence and some reasoning capacity, which can begin to have human-like experiences. So there is the worry that is beginning to be able to think like humans. That kind of worry led to, sometime last year, eggheads in that field like Elon Musk and co. gathered together and were trying to call for a pause in AI development. But whether that kind of argued for pause will exist, will happen, remains a challenge. I personally do not believe it will happen. Let's look at a few things that AI can do. Imagine you have a piece of land. You can describe the dimension of the land. You can define the topography. You can define the direction of sunlight. And you say, oh, in my family, I have 25 children. So I want a house that can accommodate me, my wife, or wives, 25 children. I want this, I want that. And you push a button. AI, very soon, will be able to give you options of designs. And should you then choose one, you push another button, it should be able to give you full architectural drawings, mechanical, electrical, structural, and even begin to give you quantities and learn from the market as well and tell you prices. So in 5 to 10 minutes, at the push of a button, you have a complete design to work with. That's AI. Well, what would that kind of thing do to all the draftsmen that work for architects? They'll be out of a job. And in fact, the average architect may also be out of a job. But the very high-class architects who know the nuances of what is really important to put into various designs are those who will be surviving more. So you are beginning to have a stronger polarity between those who are at the very top and those who have approximately nothing. That's a risk in economic terms. There are other possibilities. For example, in the military, you can begin to use AI to identify threats or prepare for threats and execute battle. At the moment, for example, the military in India is already using AI, and I will not be surprised if in the current missile launches between Iran and Israel, some AI technology is not already there. But of course, with that kind of technology, there may be some risks. When certain things happen that require human intelligence, human intervention, and that doesn't happen, you may stand a risk. If, for example, the moment Iran sent hundreds of drones to go and strike in Israel, and you left AI to itself to organize a response, you may certainly begin to have an escalation. But so far, human beings have prevailed, which is why we yet have a containment of the situation right now. Sometime in February, I think, Tyler Perry, who some of you may recognize as a Hollywood superstar, was planning to build a new studio, $800 million studio. But when he saw some demonstration from OpenAI's Sora program, that project had to be canceled. Because a lot of the things that could have been designed and done in the studio can now be done by AI. You can imagine that you want to stimulate somebody who act as, say, Bob Marley, and AI can design the face and the movement and the lyrics and everything about Bob Marley. Then all those who are supposed to be doing the facial construction, facial designs, costuming, etc., will not happen. Recently as well, a Nigerian actor, Junior Pope, died in Anambra State. They had gone to get some kind of background pictures in the River Anam area. AI can design whatever background you want for you in your movies. So AI will certainly disrupt Nollywood and at the same time presents wonderful opportunities. The future belongs to those who are going to move in that direction, especially young ones, students here. In the healthcare sector, AI has been known to be able to diagnose illnesses faster and with higher accuracy than human beings. The drug discovery process in the pharmaceutical industry takes years, but with AI, this can be hastened into a matter of weeks, if not days. In finance, you can have all kinds of algorithms that will help you do trading. At the push of a button, it recognizes which currency is doing what across the world and how to move money around so you can make a kill. At the same time as well, you can detect fraudulent activities. If, for example, you have a smart guy who is designed that every transaction that takes place in a bank, half a cent or half a kobo is taken and put into a dedicated account. I mean, the average customer will not notice that. But AI will notice the trend and be able to detect that and any other that kind of fraudulent behavior rather speedily. In the retail industry, you can go into a shop and AI can even begin to tell you and suggest things to you regarding what they know about you that will be of interest to you, instead of you coming the whole place. And it's in much the same way, you can have the store owners use whatever data they have of you to target what is sent to you for purchase. You have, of course, with drone technology and enhancements by AI, a lot can also happen in transportation. Manufacturing, inventory management, and what have you. Like I said, there's hardly any facet of life that AI will not affect. So, in Nigeria, there will be ample opportunities, like in every place else, for AI intervention to make life different. And for those who are properly prepared, meaningful. For example, in the creative industry, as I mentioned before, I mean, where I come from, you have many traditional stories. I'm from Benin, and you have many stories we learned as children. So if you punch those ones in, and using AI software, for example, called Sora, you can generate a movie. So you type in text, and a movie is generated. How about that? I'd just like to also mention, for example, education. In the interest of time, I will speak through this. You can begin to have personalized education. I mean, students are put in a class. Students learn in different ways. Some learn more by sitting in the front seat. Some at the back seat, half gisting and half learning. But with AI, you can have learning that is tuned to meet the best way you can learn. A number of companies are already in that space in Nigeria, trying to find ways to incorporate AI into what they do. Companies like 514, Mercator Technologies, even logistics companies like G&G and the like. Okay, now I've mentioned that there may be some risks. In fact, there are some risks with AI. First, we have talked about biases, which can become worsened by virtue of the learning data that it is presented with. We have talked about situations where you may have ethical dilemmas. You want to use AI to take out terrorists. And in taking that action, if you may have collateral damage of the victims themselves in there. You have, of course, job displacement. I had mentioned, using the example of the architect, that you have very good guys who will make a ton of money, and those who were in the average space will just be weeded out. There's talk about privacy concerns with systems gathering all kinds of data about you without your permission and used in ways that may not be necessarily be beneficial to you. Now, long-term risks associated with AI systems surpassing human intelligence and becoming uncontrollable is the biggest worry we have of AI today. Following from this comes the argument whether you can slow it down, shape it, or stop it, depending on how you want to manage those risks, those existential risks. So laws are being put together to try to address those risks. But even that legislative process has challenges for a number of reasons. One, the technology is advancing so rapidly that it is almost impossible for legislation to catch up with it. As with most phases of life, legislation comes behind technology. Technology is always ahead of legislation. So if technology is accelerating away, you can well imagine that for laws and rules to catch up with it will be a big challenge. Another reason is that it is being developed globally all over the place. So making rules in one country to see how you can satisfy and make up and remove the dangers, perceived dangers, for something being developed in another country is a challenge. Of course, given that it affects nearly all aspects of our lives, then it requires multi-issue collaboration. It's not a matter of getting, say, lecturers or doctors or engineers together. It requires multi-discipline to begin to fashion a way in which you can design something that can control it for the benefit of mankind. I'll just mention here that, of course, there may be unintended consequences. However, the position is that these legislations will struggle and have very limited chance of success. In spite of the fact that you have global bodies like the EU coming together to try to set up regulations, there will be rogue countries. Of course, when country A disagrees with the way in which country B does things, they say country B is a rogue country. But the competition amongst countries and the competition among companies and even the presence of rogue scientists will be such that even whatever you legislate against, somebody out there will try to do it. We've heard about gene editing, for example, in spite of the fact that there are legislations against doing that for the human beings. So my position is that because of this competition from between countries and between companies and the presence of rogue scientists and rogue countries, legislation for AI will struggle. Of course, this one talks about rogue scientists and possible risks. So you can have malicious surveillance control. I mean, growing up, you cannot just get into the Oba of Benin's palace anyhow. You cannot see the internals of it. But with satellite imagery, you practically see everything. The rules of the land there cannot stop that. You have security threats that may be remote from where you are, from AI. Conflicts can escalate if AI takes decisions without human intervention, and unnecessary hardship can be brought upon mankind. You can use it for economic espionage and intellectual property theft, for example. Okay. Now, my last two slides. Consequent upon the fact that AI is going to disrupt everything, Nigeria must prepare itself to take advantage of the good sides of it and protect itself about possible negative consequences. So Nigeria will need to invest in education and begin to establish AI-related technologies curriculum, starting from primary school through secondary to tertiary education. The one I really like more is this, what I call this skill development and training, where I argue that you need blended multi-generational classrooms. I mean, the young ones here have the speed and agility of picking up new things. The more mature workers have the experience and in deeper knowledge. And those two will need to be in the same space where you are exploring what this technology will have to bring about. Perhaps University of Lagos should be looking into that kind of blended curriculum for matured workers and young ones who are more tech savvy. And of course, all that will have to hinge on solid infrastructural development, the right deep spaces, computers, and the like. AI research and development, funds will need to be allocated. And of course, you need to have encouragement between policymakers, industry, academia, and the public to address the concerns and the opportunities. Not one single group itself can take it on. The one I consider most important on this slide has to do with the need for Nigeria to pursue what is describable as digital sovereignty. At the moment, even key decisions in the highest echelons of government are conveyed via Yahoo Mail. You can imagine that if a country is planning something and one ministry is writing to the other via Yahoo Mail, that information is already, if you like, in the open space. If at any time you disagree with the country that where Yahoo originates from and we switch off a button, you are finished. Same goes for our dependence on software like TikTok and what have you, where we put all manner of things, and the engines behind those, the people behind those, are scouring our data. Any day they want you to behave a certain way, they know what kind of information to release. And then you are beginning to be biased along those ways. Even countries as sophisticated as the United States still worry about, for example, electoral intervention by countries like Russia. Now that we do not have data in our own space, then we have a big problem. Is this moving? I'd like to leave it there, and I thank you for listening.
Thank you so much. Thank you for that very insightful lecture on preparing Nigeria for the pending AI disruption. And really enjoyed how he has been able to show that AI is something that we have to live with. We have to live with it because it has come to stay. There are good sides and there are risks associated with AI. But then we can prepare ourselves, position ourselves to take advantage of the good sides of AI while also protecting ourselves from the risk that are associated with AI-based knowledge and its utilization. So I'd like that we please give once more a round of applause for Mr. Nedo Osanyade for that lecture. Now next on the item, we have some tributes to take, and we'll take just three now, three short ones, and then we will continue with the second, we'll have the second lecture. And to start off, I would be inviting the Deputy Vice Chancellor, Management Services, Professor Lucien Chukwu, for his tributes and goodwill message. Please, a round of applause for him. A round of applause. Let's keep clapping until he gets here.
Thank you. The chairman of the occasion, Dr. Mark Onjuala, that had to leave due to some other exigencies. It may also interest you to know that Dr. Mark Onjuala, apart from being the husband of Professor Mark Onjuala, is one of the two special eminent personalities that are members of Senate of the University of Lagos. The guest speaker, Nedo Osoyande, well, they have been introduced as the chairman of Belema Oil, but we know you in Unilag as the man behind the transformation of our Unilag guest houses. Let me also acknowledge our Vice Chancellor, who is ably represented by the Deputy Vice Chancellor of Academics and Research. The protocols has been fully established, but however, permit me to still recognize a few retirees from science, those who laid the background, those under whose shoulders that we are climbing today to where we are. Professor, Distinguished Professor Kayode Amond, former VC, who was also former dean. I am highly enthused to see Professor T.V.I. Akpata, a former council member of this great university, as a congregation representative. I still remember your elections. during that period. I must not fail to also acknowledge one of the three women in zoology department that actually affected my life in so many ways. I am talking about Professor Otubanjo, who happened to be my neighbor until she retired. Professor Makonjola is not here for obvious reasons and for good reasons. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, the honoree of today, Professor Rosemary Egonmwan, and her dear husband, Sir Andrew Egonmwan. Dean of Science, HOD, Zoology, and all other distinguished members of the faculty and the university who are here today. Let me stop there. My tribute is really very short, I must tell you. But I felt compelled to speak today for a number of reasons. The very first reason is that Professor Egonmwan, though she belongs to the Department of Zoology, but both of us belong to the same academic family under the leadership of Professor William Ose Odiete, the foremost environmental physiologist we have in Nigeria. In those early years, when I was still an undergraduate, that was when Professor Egonmwan was completing her master's in environmental physiology. So I can tell you that she was one of those that steadied my hands in the area of environmental physiology. And to God be the glory, she went to Oxford, came back, and today I had the singular privilege of not only being her mentee, but I also became a member of staff and her colleague in the Department of Zoology. What does it tell you? When you work hard and wash your hands, my dear students, you can always dine with a what? With a kings. Prof, I just want to say congratulations on attaining this milestone age of 70 years. Congratulations for retiring meritoriously, because where we are coming from is very far. I still remember those days when you were cuddling your twins and the other children during the period of your early career years. We appreciate you for what you've been able to do in the department, in the faculty, in the university. Your legacies and your mentees will be there to propagate the major virtues you left behind. Chief amongst them is your virtue of humility. Professor Egonmwan, you are indeed an epitome of humility. Despite the fact that you're a princess and you came from a privileged background, and you also have a privileged home, your humility is infectious. We promise you that we'll keep the flag flying. And our prayer is that as you retire, though you're not tired, you're still there to play the boardroom politics in Vitafoam as the chairman, that the good Lord will guide you, give you strength, give you sound knowledge, and I will always be there for us to consult you on various issues of environmental physiology, conservation, and all other aspects of university life. Professor Egonmwan and Sir Andrew Egonmwan, I say congratulations. We thank you for what you've been able to do for us. And we appreciate all you have done at the University of Lagos. Thank you very much, and God bless you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, thank you, thank you, Professor Lucien Chukwu. Thank you for that remarks. I'd like to also, at this point, call forward Professor Ayodele Asenua, the Deputy Vice Chancellor, Development Services. She will be speaking in her own capacity at this time. So please, a round of applause for her as she comes forward.
Thank you very much for the opportunity. The chairman, distinguished guests, it is a honor to stand here to then give my own personal tribute to Professor Egonmwan. I remember that I was very glad when I found that I had to represent the Vice Chancellor, which meant that I didn't have to go out with them this morning, because when I got this invitation, I wanted to be here. And then when the official duties came, I was quite glad that I was not one of those scheduled to go. And why is that? I didn't know Professor Egonmwan very early in my career here at University of Lagos. I got to know her much later. But one thing that I found was that I need to say that you don't need to talk to somebody to mentor them. You don't need to talk to somebody to coach them. You just need to be. Just being, and Professor Egonmwan, I want to say that just being, just wearing the smile, just always being humble, just always acknowledging has been enough to coach me and to endear you to me. Thank you. Thank you for teaching me how to have a heart of gratitude. Even today, I understand how important being grateful is to you, because you referred to an incident that I consider very inconsequential, and I learned that and appreciate it. Thank you for taking me, small as I am, as your sister, and also honoring me in the office that God has given to me. I will miss seeing you around, and those moments will stop and you give me the hug. Thank you so very much, and I wish you very well. Thank you.
A round of applause for Professor Ayodele Asenua. We will take another set of tributes, but this time around, one that is digitally produced. So let's have this round of tributes.
Dear Professor Princess Rosemary Egonmwan, on attaining the age of 70, I have subsequently retired for the artist service of the Department of Zoology, University of Lagos. Professor Rosemary Egonmwan is an amiable, kind-hearted, loving personality and a great scholar who has contributed a lot in the field of medical physiology. She will be greatly missed in the department because she has mentored so many people, and I'm wishing her an happy retirement, in good health, in sound mind, in peace, in joy. And I pray that all her dreams will be fulfilled. God will keep her in good health and in sound mind. Congratulations, dear Professor Rosemary Egonmwan. Happy retirement from active service of the Department of Zoology, University of Lagos. Thank you all.
Happy birthday to you, ma. Thank God for your life, a life well lived. Very humble woman. Wishing you the best. Wishing you long life and prosperity. And I wish you good health. Thanks for all you do. And thanks for all you still doing. We love you. Baba.
Sanya Bamidele. I'm from the Department of Zoology, University of Lagos. I met Professor Egonmwan in 1999 when I joined the services of this great university. And since I've been relating with her, I know Professor Egonmwan to be a very wonderful person, a very good professor, gentle, easygoing, and a quintessential example of humility. And I pray that God Almighty will grant her long life and prosperity. Well, she has prosperity already, but if I say more prosperity, there's nothing wrong with that. God will give her more prosperity in Jesus' name. Long life for Professor Egonmwan.
This is a very great opportunity to say thank you to my teacher from 100 level to PhD level. She makes every subject look very simple. With her own action of gentility, I have observed her in so many ways that are worthy of emulation. I wish you the best of what life has to offer you during this your retirement. And most of the time, I'm indebted to Professor Rosemary Egonmwan over issues of my health. She's so concerned over my health. She doesn't want me to eat the wrong thing. She wants me to have the right exercises. Oh God, I'm going to miss all that. But anyways, I love you and I wish you the best. Happy birthday.
I'd like to use this opportunity to congratulate and felicitate with Professor Egonmwan on the occasion of her retirement from her service at the University of Lagos. I recall that my coming to the University of Lagos was partly due to her insistence, and I recall also quite a number of challenges that I had with taking up the decision to join the Department of Zoology. But she was really a source of encouragement, and today I can say for sure that decision has not been one which I regret. And so on this day, I want to say thank you for all that you have done. Thank you for your service to the University of Lagos and to the Department of Zoology. And I wish you a very peaceful and blessed retirement days ahead.
My mama, my mentor, my PhD supervisor, my all, you have been nice, you have labored. We pray that the fruit of your labor you will enjoy even in your retirement in Jesus' name. I'm wishing you a happy retirement, age with grace, and enjoy your rest, and enjoy more of your family that you have been laboring for. God bless you. This is Dr. Mrs. Olaleru, your first female PhD student. Congratulations, ma.
Good day, everyone. My name is Dr. Temitope Shukamu. I'm a senior lecturer at the Department of Zoology, and it's my singular honor and joy to be able to celebrate our wonderful Professor Princess Rosemary Egonmwan on this retirement from the university after 40 plus years of service. I particularly want to thank you, Ma, and celebrate you. You've been a mentor even right from my undergraduate days, then to my postgraduate, and then when I became a staff of the department. And your mentorship has been beyond just academic. It's also been as a woman, as a mother, and basically personally as well. I pray that in this next phase of your life, in this your retirement age, that the Lord will bless you, your children and grandchildren will surround your table, and you will enjoy it in good health in the name of Jesus. Thank you very much, Ma, and have a lovely retirement celebration.
Morning. Congratulations to Professor Rosemary Egonmwan on her retirement from the services of the University of Lagos upon attainment of 70 years of age. I've known Mama Egonmwan since 1999 when I gained admission to study zoology at the University of Lagos. And since then, she has been of tremendous assistance and mentorship to me, being a good teacher and a researcher by excellence. She was also my undergraduate seminar supervisor, and that was when I had close contact with her. She was highly meticulous, highly cerebral, and humane. Upon her retirement, I'm wishing her sound physical and mental health, tranquility, prosperity, and enjoyment post-retirement. Congratulations, ma'am.
Hello. Happy birthday, Professor Egonmwan, and happy retirement as well. I'm glad to be associated with you. You've been my teacher from year one up until PhD, and my mentor as well. When I started work in University of Lagos, even very supportive till my departure from the university. So I just want to say happy birthday to you. I wish you the very best of your retirement. I know that you are retired, but you're not tired. I know that you'll be very busy with so many things. I just want to let you know that I'll always be there in case you call, you need me. Just call on me. I'll always rally around you and support you in any way I can. I wish you good health, long life, all you desire. Happy birthday, man. Congratulations.
My name is... On the zoology, there are several other tributes that we ought to have taken at this point, not the zoology one. So that's the one we're taking. Apologies.
I am Olukayode Amond, retired distinguished professor of microbiology and former vice chancellor of Elizabeth University. It's my pleasure to join members of the zoology department in wishing Professor Rosemary Egonmwan a happy retirement from the University of Lagos. Rosemary and I have come a long way since the past 50 years because we were classmates and we matriculated together on the same day. And since then, we have been friends. Our relationship has been sustained by our chemistry that aligned. Rosemary is a very dependable, reliable friend and someone that you can trust. She was a triangular student like me because we only go from classroom to dining hall to the library. And Rosemary would never be in company of anyone that was not serious. And if you notice that all her friends at that time made with minimum of second class upper. Rosemary is the best specimen of motherhood because she sacrificed her time and everything she had for her family. And that actually caused a delay in her academic progression. But we want to thank God that she made it to the top. So it's my pleasure to wish her well in her future endeavor. Thank you very much.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Professor Oluwole Familoni, former Deputy Vice Chancellor of Academics and Research at the University of Lagos and former Dean of Science. I'm here this afternoon to come and celebrate our retiring Professor Rosemary Egonmwan, Professor Princess of Benin Kingdom. Professor Egonmwan, I'm a distinguished professor of zoology, graduate of Oxford University in England, well reputable in all her dreams. She is quite easily able to relate with. She's always smiling, making you very easy when you are with her, and making everything very pleasant to deal with. She does not carry her age difference with that between us and her in relating to us, but is very pleasantly. And not only me, with almost everybody that is around her. And so we find it very easy today to come and celebrate our retirement. Even though we don't like her to retire yet, because it's going to be lost to the university, but it's going to be an advantage to her. She should retire when she's still useful to herself and to her family. And I'm happy that she has even got something to be doing that she can be doing while she is retired as the chairman of Vitafo. I congratulate her on her retirement after a distinguished career as a professor of zoology, and I wish her a retirement in health, in joy and happiness, her children, her husband and her family around her in good health, and I wish that we see her always and she'll be in good health in Jesus' name. Thank you very much.
It gives me great pleasure to be part of this ceremony.
and I thank the organizers for making it possible for me. If I'm to go down memory lane, Rosemary and I met as graduate students in the then Department of Biological Sciences. She was doing a master's in zoology while I was on a PhD program in microbiology. We were friends along with some others, especially the late Dr. Taiwo Odubela. It was always fun to go to Rosemary's house because she was the only one married amongst us to eat her delicious meals, as she loved cooking, the left-handed Rosemary. We all continued our academic pursuit, and Rosemary, being the left-handed brainy that she is, got admission to go to Oxford University for her PhD. The relationship continued. When she came back, we became academic colleagues. Our offices were on the first floor of the science building. She was in the zoology research lab with late Dr. Adeoye, and my own office was next to the zoology departmental office. We continued this relationship, young women raising children. Unlike those of us here in Lagos, where we had our kids, we were busy taking our children for extra school lessons and all that. Rosemary, on the other hand, was always going to the UK because her children were schooling there. So you could see the challenge of a nursing mother being coping with academic life. But we thank God today that everything went well. The children are doing well. And if we look on the other side of the coin as friends, we became close family friends, being there for each other. Our children have about the same ages. We were there, she was there for me for my children's weddings. I was there at a Khan's wedding, been there with the children, with the grandchildren coming along. And it has been a wonderful time together. I can refer to her as a very reliable friend. And on the occasion of this, her retirement, I wish her a more fulfilled life with the children and grandchildren surrounding her table. I wish her good health, and I wish her all that she would love to have for herself in this retirement age. I wish you well and welcome to my club.
Professor Rosemary Egonmwan, an Oxford educated academic with numerous accolades, has been a cherished colleague for over 3 decades. Upon starting my PhD at the then Department of Biological Sciences, I was warmly embraced by Professor Egonmwan and other young female lecturers who treated me as a peer rather than just a student. Our shared backgrounds, including our Catholic faith and origins from the then Bendel State, strengthened our bond. She is a very kind-hearted individual who once gifted me with a beautiful rosary during one of her trips abroad, a gesture I deeply appreciate as a Catholic. Our paths coincided once more as we both delivered our farewell speeches during the February Senate meeting, which happened to fall on my birthday just before her own retirement. As she enters this new phase of her life, I extend my sincere wishes for a retirement filled with fulfillment and joy.
Congratulations, Rosemary! Congratulations! Can you believe it? Only 42 long years we first met in the Department of Zoology as the first two female lecturers. Can you believe it? I guess the females now double the boys. There must be something good the females are doing. That's why we keep on employing them. We are not only celebrating your 70th years of life,
but also celebrating your service to the University of Lagos, where you have impacted so many staff and students with all that you have acquired in life. I also congratulate you also for getting to the zenith of your career. Not everyone can say so. So we give God all the glory. As you continue in this new phase of life, I wish you all God's blessing. I pray that in the name of Jesus, you will have good health and you have many more years to spend time with your husband, children, grandchildren, and all your friends around. You have time to do a lot more than you can imagine. Retirement is not boring, so don't be scared of going into retirement.
Praise God. I got to know Professor Rosemary Egonmwan when I joined the service of Unilag in 1995. Throughout my encounter of 15 years, as a colleague, she maintained a loving, agreeable outlook and attitude to both young and old colleagues in the department, particularly as HOD. I actually got to know her from a closer perspective through Professor Vicky Akpata, who was my friend and next door neighbor in the office. Professor Rosemary joined the cooperative union I managed for several years. She was a consistent, straightforward participant, meeting her obligations as at when due. We were the exclusive teachers of a course, Comparative Animal Embryology, and realized the need to train and mentor younger lecturers. We were able to do this effectively because we cooperated with each other. Also, for a long period, the three masquerade in the department, that is including Professor Mark Odiola, taught another course, Introductory Zoology. Commitment to service was our motto and practice. In these years, I managed to have a close interaction with her, particularly as I managed the departmental manuals. She gave me a free hand. Professor Rosemary Egonmwan interacted smoothly and rewardingly with me. As her name signifies, she's a lovely, forthright, easygoing lady with drive and ambition to excel. She's also trustworthy. Above all, she's a passionate mother, as she is ever ready to undertake discussions about the well-being and progress of her children. She's also a dedicated Catholic Christian woman from her interactions and utterances. To wrap it up, I consider she is truly royal in all her ways. Elegant, quietly forging forward in her activities. I sincerely wish her a happy and blessed retirement with long life, in good health and peace. The Lord keep us all.
All right, so we would continue from there. later on. We need to take the second lecture now. Professor Kemabonta, please. All right, so just a little change in the program. We're making some adjustments to it. We want to take the presentation of plaques and gifts now. But before I go on, I need to acknowledge the presence of the Deputy Vice Chancellor, Academic and Research, Professor Bola Obo. Thank you, Ma, for coming. Also acknowledge the presence of Professor M. Olushaki. Thank you for coming, Ma. I think I saw Professor Olayinka from the Department of Chemistry. Thank you so much. Professor Osarere, I think I saw, yes. Thank you for coming, Ma. Please, we would recognize others as we go on. So we'll take the presentation of gifts and plaques at this point. Can we have the gifts in front, please? We'll take the gifts and plaques now. So we have a presentation of plaques. The first presentation will be made to the GMD of Vitafoam, Mr. Taiwo Adeyemi. Ably represented. So we'll make that presentation to the GMD of Vitafoam, Mr. Taiwo Adeyemi, and his representative, Mr. Shola Owade, will be taking this presentation, this gift on his behalf. Please come forward, sir. And I'd like to invite Professor Olubumi Otubanjo to please come forward and make this presentation on our behalf. Sincere apologies. There was a typographical error in your initials on the video. Your initials is AO.
On behalf of the Department of Zoology, this presentation is made to Mr. Taiwo Adeyemi. Adeyemi. There's an error there. We're sorry for the error in the name. Vitafoam GMD CEO. As mega sponsor of the Valedictory program in honor of Professor Princess Rosemary Iriowen Egonmwan, Fellow of the Zoological Society of Nigeria, that is held this day, 16th April 2024. We present to you in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit.
Thank you very much, ma. The next presentation will be made to the celebrant of the day. And I'd like to invite once again, I'd like to invite Professor Lucian Chukwu to please help make this presentation to Professor Rosemary Egonmwan. Prof, please come forward. Please let's clap, let's keep clapping.
Let me also have the Dean of Science. Professor Egonmwan, it is indeed very humbling and a great deal of joy that I present this plaque from the Department of Zoology, which happens to be my mother department before I moved over to Marine Sciences in 1995, on your retirement from the services of the University of Lagos on the 10th of March, 2024. Congratulations, ma'am.
Congratulations once again. The next presentation will be made to the guest speaker whose presentation was taken earlier on, Mr. Nedo Osanyade, and that will be made by Professor J.K. Saliu. Professor Saliu, please come forward. Please let's keep clapping. Let's keep clapping. Thank you so much.
On behalf of the Department of Zoology, I make this presentation to you. We appreciate you and thank you so much for the lecture. God bless you. Yeah.
More music on trendybeats.com.
Highway, passing my way. This kind of body done the cause of migraine.
And when we leave, if we do, I'm your way.
Thank you.
Or if you want, if you do, I'm my way. I wait to be shut, I don't take. You tell me, and I know they go by one day.
Thank you, sir. Okay, the next presentation, we just want to finish up with the presentation of plaques so that we'll take the lectures afterward. The next presentation is to the second speaker, Professor Alexander Ogumba and Professor E.T. Idowu will be receiving it on his behalf. HOD, sir. If you're receiving this award on behalf of Professor Alexander Ogumba, and I'd like to invite Professor Bamidele Akinsanya to please come forward and make this presentation. Professor Akinsanya, okay.
On behalf of the Department of Zoology, University of Lagos, I present this plaque to Professor Obin Alexander Ogumba. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. I'd like to invite someone who on this day we celebrate Professor Egonmwan. We'd like to invite her very first PhD student who is here, Dr. Adeshina Adelaja. I know he has something to say. So please, let's give a round of applause to him. Our very first PhD student. Several of our students have now are professors, doctors in different fields.
Thank you very much. Good afternoon, everybody. I'd like to stand on the existing protocol so that I can have more time to talk about my Oga, my Madam. Prof Ma, I would like to join in the congratulations. Where is she? Okay, I can see her. I'd like to join in the conversation and the congratulatory message that have been extended to you. I had the singular privilege of carrying that title of our very first PhD student. And that's a title that nobody can contest with me. And it's a rare privilege. So I got to know Professor Egonmwan in 1998, actually 1997, when I walked into Professor Makonjola's office that I want to come back for a PhD after 10 years of staying out. I haven't completed my master's in 1988. So 1987, I came back. So it was Professor Makonjola that introduced me to Professor Egonmwan, because she asked me, what are you looking at to study for your PhD? I said, well, I like to work with snails. And you know, Professor Egonmwan is the mama of snails all over Nigeria, all over Africa. I don't think there's any authority about snail physiology, nutrition, and everything. So that's how I got to know her in 98. And of course, in 1998, there was no internet, was just emerging, evolving. Guest speaker, there was no AI. So anything that you want to do in the academic field, you must cite the papers. You must see them physically and all that. And that was one area that Mama really came through for me. If you have been a student, you know our library is incomparable. She has a rich library of academic journals from all over the world. So I would just sit in her office. I have direct access to her office. I will see, even when she's leaving, she will leave me in the office and I'll start going through the literature and all of that. So we agreed on the topic. I actually wanted to work on snail nutrition, but she made me divert into physiology because that's our field. So it was a combination of snail nutrition and physiology that I worked on. And one thing that I enjoyed working with her is that if she wants you to do something and you have a superior argument, she will let you be as long as you can defend your position. And that was the relationship that I had with her. Mama was what I call her, very strict academic mother hen. She had that mother hen part of her, but she also had that strict academic side of her. So if you don't do what she asks you to do, you'll be in trouble. But if you can do what she has encouraged you to do, then you are home and dry. So let me not bore you. It was a long literature, long association. But one thing that I know that Mama did for me, because she's a member of what we call the Malacological Society of London. And I think then, back then, the annual due was 39 pounds, a little under 40 pounds. Mama registered, she's a member, she also registered me as a member of that society. And for years, all through my PhD program, she was paying my annual subscription. Thank you very much, Ma. I don't know of any lecturer that pays annual subscription in hard currency for her student. She did it all through my PhD years, and that's something that I am eternally grateful for. And I've continued in that society up to today. So let me just round up by saying, Mama, thank you very much. And let me thank our husband too, Sir Egonmwan, for letting Mama express herself and be who we are all celebrating today. Thank you very much, sir. Mama has sown in the lives of so many people. And now that she's retiring, I believe it is time for her to begin to reap the fruit of her labor. And that is scriptural. The Bible says that as long as the earth remains, seed time and harvest time shall not cease. Mama, you will reap the fruit of your labor. You will have bountiful harvest in good health, in peace, and in prosperity. Thank you very much for coming to celebrate my Oga with me. It is really a great privilege. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Adelaja. Now we want to take presentation of gifts by the department, the unit, as well as from the faculty. So please, let's prepare to get that done now. Presentation of gifts. Please, let's mobilize and have that. But before that comes up, I just want to recognize a few more persons, family, friends, relations to Professor Egonmwan, who have come to grace this occasion. First on the list is Mr. and Mrs. Tunde Lawal. We recognize and appreciate your presence. Cornell V.L. Ogomo, we thank you for coming. Mr. and Mrs. Agbontai, thank you for coming. We recognize you. Mrs. Vivian Ezioba, thank you for coming. The Smagoga girls, we recognize you all. Thank you for coming. The Netete girls, we also recognize you. Thank you for coming. Also want to recognize Mrs. Osa Demuren. Thank you. We recognize and appreciate your presence. And last but not least on this list here is Mr. and Mrs. Peter Omakoro. Thank you for coming. So can we have the gifts? Presentation of gifts now, please. Presentation of gifts from the department, from the conservation unit. Please continue with the tributes while that comes up.
My name is Professor Adiara Ogumba from University of Ibadan. My dear Professor Rosemary Egonmwan, Princess of Benin Kingdom, you have been an inspiration to me, particularly in the latter days of my academic life, or academic career rather. I thank you for the privilege of knowing you. I pray that as you enter into a new phase of your life, you will be more fulfilled in Jesus' mighty name. The Lord God will bless you with divine joy and happiness for the rest of the days of your life through Christ our Lord. Amen. Happy retirement, ma'am.
Happy birthday, Professor Rosemary Egonmwan. I call you Molly. I thank you for the knowledge you imparted on us when we were very young in our first degree. You were a wonderful teacher, a great mentor, a senior colleague that does not really behave like one, but you always, you know, take us all as if we are your children. Thank you, Mommy, for being there for us. I want to wish you a wonderful birthday, because abundant grace on you. I pray that you continue to live in the presence of the Lord all the days of your life. I pray as you leave, that the good Lord will not leave you. His mighty hand will be for you, for your business, and your next level. Happy retirement.
Rosemary, I'm thrilled a bit that you're about to join the 70s Club. I can assure you, it's a really nice club to belong to. And I also want to congratulate you on all the things that you've achieved in your life up until now, and many more to come, of course. When I was first asked to take over the supervision of your DPhil, I was a bit surprised because I knew nothing at all about African land snails, but you taught me an awful lot. I can't remember whether Emezi was with us when I first got to know you, but I distinctly remember your telling me that you were expecting twins. So I said, right, we'll get the DPhil thesis done first and then we'll do the twins. And that's exactly what you did. It was brilliant. And since then, back in Nigeria, you have worked so hard with your students, trying to keep the show on the road, when every now and then, in fact far too often, the universities were closed down and you had to manage your students in the best way that you knew possible. You've done wonderful things in Nigeria. As you know, Nigeria is very close to my heart because it was the first place that I did fieldwork in Africa. And it's not an easy place to work, but you've brought up a wonderful family and you've had a wonderfully successful career. So all our family, who are very, very fond of you, David, my husband, and our three children, Emily and Thea and Jack, send you our very best wishes for your 70th birthday. And we look forward to seeing you again sometime soon. Love from me. Bye.
Oh, this is such a delight. First of all, Asusa, thank you so much for including me in this. I would have hated to miss it. Your mother is an extraordinary woman, and I suspect nothing I'll say will be new to anybody. But thank you so much for making me a part of this extraordinary, I hope a surprise for many others, for this remarkable woman whose heart is fixed in Christ. What I'll say first, and probably what will cover everything about your mother, is that she has been given grace by God to hold on so tenaciously to him. I don't think I know anyone whose first thought, first instinct is not to please God. And God has more than rewarded that delight he has in her. She has, it's hard to say, what gifts do we count on? She has the gift of care. This is a mother of mothers whose heart goes out not only to her kids, but she never forgets my kids, never forgets us. And who has this devotion to family that cuts across everything else. I must say her humility for what she stands for is an eye-opener. This is a clever woman, quite apart from anything else. She's at the top of her profession, and we all know that. But this is a woman who comes from a distinguished background, royal no less, and she carries this so absolutely lightly. You guys are lucky to call her your mother, and all else who are here to call her your friend. My dear Rosemary, thank you. Thank you for a friendship that has endured the years. Thank you for a care that has overcome so much. Thank you for not forgetting.
We would take presentation of gifts to Professor Egonmwan by the department. And I call on the head of department to make that presentation. Professor Iti Idowu.
Please, I want to invite the professors in the Department of Zoology to join me to present our departmental gift to our retiring professor, Rosemary Egonmwan. Please, Professor of Zoology, Professor Kemabonta, Professor Saliu, Professor Akinsuan, please join me at this platform. Let's clap for this great professor as they come. Please clap for your professors, please. I want also to invite Professor Gon to please come. Down sometimes I feel like please, ma'am, can you please come up? Let's put it in the center. Center. Prof, ma'am, if you don't mind, can you just step up, ma'am? Let's clap for Prof as he comes. Egonmwan, you meant so much to us. If we give you a car, a new car, you want more than that. But you know the situation of things in the country. So with our deepest love and deep appreciation for a life that is committed to excellence and mentoring, on behalf of the Department of Zoology, we want to present this little gift to you in appreciation of your service to our department and to university at large. Thank you, ma'am.
The next presentation is from the conservation unit. I call on Dr. Laleru, please join us here. Dr. Onodeko, Dr. Akeredolu, please join. so that we can make this presentation. After this, the mentees, Prof's mentees, will be making a presentation, which will be led by Dr. Adelaja. So please be on standby. Dr. Nodeko, we need you up here.
On behalf of the Natural Resources Conservation Unit, I want to make this presentation to our mama. She's the first head of units that we've ever had, and she's leaving us behind now. Thank you very much for the space you have set for us and what we are going to be missing as you are going. So thank you very much, ma. It is something that you will cherish because it has to do with nature. Yes, we are natural, and I know you love nature. So thank you very much, ma. Congratulations, ma. So this is a picture of a mangrove swamp where she took her periwinkles and all those specimens and the animals that are there. You know she will love it. Mangrove swamps is very close to us here as part of the lagoon environment, but very behind Faculty of Science we have a very good mangrove. So thank you, ma'am. Yes.
Dr. Lidlanger, please come forward. So then you would.
Mama, this is a token of our appreciation of all your efforts and good work in the lives of those of us that are your mentees, your PhD students. So we say thank you very much for who you are and what you do. We trust that going forward, God will continue to renew your youth in strength, in peace, and in happiness. Congratulations, man, and happy retirement.
Your feedback.
I'm overwhelmed. All I can say is thank you to my students, my lovely undergraduates that are here. I really appreciate your coming because you must have missed some lectures to come here. Thank you very much. I thank the other guests that are here to celebrate my special day when I'm technically bowing out of this university. But like I told the Vice Chancellor, I will still be very much part of the system. I've been here for 50 years. This year makes it 50 years. I first came in direct entry to read zoology. Like I always tell people, I'm not a medicine reject. I've always wanted to study zoology. And 50 years ago, I matriculated. And I'm leaving the system 50 years later. So students, you people should know that whatever has a beginning must also have an ending. But at the same time, try and make your mark. When I graduated, I'm referring this to the undergraduate, I had the best result in zoology. And because of that, there's no hard and fast rule. If you work hard, you will get the result. I had the best result, and as a result, the University of Lagos awarded us what we call academic scholarship. So you can see that from my HSC, I've not paid a single school fees. It's not that I can't afford it, because of hard work. So please, my dear, hard work is still possible. If you have not been working hard, please make a U-turn. Make a U-turn now and say, from now onwards, I will be a friend of the library. When you are there, it was a triangle. We go from the hostel to the lecture room. From lecture room, we go to the library. And from library, back to the hostel. So this, my speech is directed at the students. Because they say, catch them young. So please, work very hard and you will get your results. And I thank the others, my friends, my relations, and all others who are here to honor me. Thank you so much. That's all I can say. I really appreciate you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I want to thank the Vital Four for sponsoring this. You've done so well. Thank you so much. It's a pleasure associating with Vital Foam. And I'm happy that I'm part and parcel of Vital Foam. Thank you so much, Vital Foam, for sponsoring this event. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
At this moment, I'd like to just quickly acknowledge a few dignitaries, special guests who have joined us online, who have been with us, Professor Tio Ogundepe, the immediate past Vice Chancellor of the University of Lagos. We acknowledge and appreciate your presence. Dr. Morege, one of her PhD students, also joined online. Dr. Amaze, all the way from Canada. All around the world, we have people joining this program. Thank you all for your participation. I'd like to invite Sir Andy Egonmwan to give his remarks. Sir Andy Egonmwan, sir. This occasion cannot be complete without a word from you. So please, let's give a round of applause to him.
Madam Vice Chancellor, ably represented by the various deputies. Very, very distinguished ladies and gentlemen. Well, I'm short of words. But one thing I can say is that I thank the Almighty for this day. It has been a long way. 50 years in the life of anybody is no joke. My wife spent 50 years of her life at the University of Lagos. And we can only give God the glory for all her achievements. My wife was to go to the University of Ibadan, which I attended. But about 50 years ago, I convinced her as an undergraduate to change over to the University of Lagos and see the crowd that we have here today. I don't think I would have been able to go to Ibadan to accept this kind of ovation. So I thank you all immensely from the very bottom of my heart for the warm and very cordial, but very emotional send-off that you have all come together to give to my wife. It is something that we will never forget. Well, for very many of you, you might be wondering, why are the children not even here? Well, it is that on the 10th of March, my wife was 70, which is the official retirement age for the university. And the children and the grandchildren all came from their respective corners to come and celebrate it. That is why it is not possible for them all to be here today. But I can assure you of one thing. They will know and see the kind of mother that they have and the respect that she commands from the university community, which she has been associated with for the past 50 years. In thanking those of you here present, we must not fail, it has been said by so many, to acknowledge those founding fathers of the university, especially founding fathers of the faculty and founding fathers of the Department of Zoology. So wherever they are, I say, for those of them who are no longer around, may God grant their souls peaceful repose. And in particular, I want to single out Professor Yoloye, because as young married couples, each time my wife came home, each time my wife came home, I asked what is happening in the university. But I thank God that I haven't gone through it all. I know some of the politics of the university. And she will tell me this problem, that problem, that problem. And I always said, discuss your problem with Professor Yoloye. So I say, may his soul rest in perfect peace. 50 years. I look at it and I say to myself, what are we leaving behind for the institution that has done a lot for us? I'm proud of two things. Number one is that this is not just my wife taking a degree or her degrees from the University of Lagos and eventually rising to the position of professor. I am happy that we are keeping the University of Lagos in line in the family, because one of our daughters is a medical graduate of this university. And more importantly, yours sincerely, after my economics degree at the University of Ibadan, I took an LLB degree from the University of Lagos. So it's something that we are very, very proud of, and that which we will continue to maintain as a family tradition, that one of us or one of them who we are leaving behind, the grandchildren, at least should be a product of the University of Lagos, because we value the institution. Well, 50 years, I can say, is like I have virtually been all alone. Because each time I wanted my wife to go anywhere with me, she would say, but I have my students to teach. That is my wife, committed to her duties and her responsibilities. But now, I can sit back and tell her that, look, when all these ceremonies are over, we can, two of us, travel to any part of the world and remain there without her telling me I need to go back to my students to go and teach. So I am happy to that extent. It's the same way even at home. You can say a housekeeper has been virtually responsible for my upkeep over the last 50 years. Now, I can sit back and I tell my wife, this is what I want. And she's not saying, I have to wake up at 7 o'clock because I have to drive to the University of Lagos to teach. So, that makes me a selfish man, but that is the way it is. But I'm grateful to it, for it. Indeed, I thank the Almighty that she came in here in 1974. She came, she saw, and she conquered. What is left for us to say? The videos and what have you of this wonderful reception will be kept for a long time to come in our archives. So, in thanking the University of Lagos, I have to extend that thanks to the faculty, to her colleagues, even the deputy, listening to the deputy vice chancellor talk about her. I feel honestly elated. I feel proud that yes, not just a princess, not just an academic, not just a peace-loving woman, but everything that a man can expect from a woman. So I thank you, my dear wife, for all that you have been. Because we were married right from the world go. I have never really had the opportunity of mixing with the university community. We have always lived outside the university. Today, I am able to sit back and say, yes, this is what my wife has built up for herself over the last 50 years. And I thank you, my dear wife, for being what you are. Like I said, a lot has been said about her. I can only be repeating it. Is it academics? I mean, she came out right from the secondary school, St. Maria Goretti. She was the best student in the state in her school certificate. She went up to Federal School of Science. She had a federal government scholarship. She went up to, you know, the University of Lagos. She had a federal government scholarship. She went up to Oxford University. She had a Commonwealth scholarship. What else can you expect from a woman? Mom, we are all of us. Esosa, Ameze, Ekan and Ivie, Eyozua and Idia, we are all extremely proud of you. And we will never forget what you are or what you have been in our life. Can you imagine? She went up to Oxford University with the firstborn. After 4 years, she came back to Nigeria with four children, a girl and a set of twins. I remember when she went for to defend her thesis, she was very heavy, and the supervisor said, or the examiner said, sit down, sit down. She said, no, I am not going to sit down. I'm going to stand like everybody else. A month or two later on, she had a set of twins. What else can a man expect from the woman? So for you younger ones, the sky is your limit. The sky is your limit. We are already on our way out. Like we say in our club, we are in the departure lounge. We are in the departure lounge. We are leaving the country for you. But there is a lot to be done for our dear country, Nigeria. Not just you alone, but also for my children, wherever they are. I tell them, there is no place like home. East or west, home remains the best. So, I thank the Lord Jesus for all that we have been through. And my wife, too, I thank her for also being very close to Jesus like I am. And if you put everything in the hands of the Lord, nothing is impossible. So I thank the university, I thank the faculty, I thank my wife's colleagues, I thank the supervisor, anybody who has in one way or the other been connected with what my wife has become today. I thank you all, and may God bless you all and protect you all. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir. Please, a round of applause to him as he returns. Heartfelt words of appreciation. So we are rounding off this program, even as I hand over to Professor Kemabunta.
Thank you so much. Please let's jam our hands together for the MC. He's done so well, so well. We want to...
Sorry, I need to recognize the following persons. Mrs. Igor Osagie, I will recognize you. Thank you so much. Mrs. Nosa Asowata, thank you so much. We recognize you. We recognize the entire members of the Benin Royal Family. Please, let's give them a round of applause. All members of the Benin Royal Family, we recognize and appreciate you. All old school students, we recognize and appreciate you. Thank you so much.
Yeah, just all protocols observed. We want to thank God for a life that our mother impacted on all of us. Yesterday, I was going with the students, and I asked them, I'm sure Prof didn't teach you people. They said she taught us 200 level embryology. I said, really? So there's nobody who has passed through zoology or some of the biological sciences that she did not teach. Thank you so much. We appreciate our mama for, she came with her two legs and she's gone out with her two legs. Let's put our hands together for God. Thank God. It's the Lord's doing and we are grateful to God. She is the last of the three musketeers, our princess. The beautiful lady, ever cheerful, ever smiling, but very humble. And a fellow of the Zoological Society of Nigeria. Please, let's put our hands together for her. We want to thank our VC, ably represented, and the Dean, the HOD, members of the Zoology Department. We want to thank the two speakers, Mr. Nedo and Professor Ogumba. Professor Ogumba's talk, we still listen to it as we eat, as we continue with our food. We want to thank all those who gave in kind and cash. Yeah, I think there's a little mix-up. Yes, Vitaphone gave us the T-shirt. You can see I'm wearing one. And they also gave us the souvenirs that you are all taking away. But every other thing was handled by Zoology Department and some of the lecturers and close friends of the department. So we thank every one of them. We want to thank Vitaphone for ever being there with us. And we thank the princesses who are here, the Reverend Fathers and the Reverend Bishops. We thank you so much. We want to appreciate all her doctoral students, her mentees, and her unit. And we want to say, the Lord be with all of you, especially all you students who took your time to come here. Thank you so much. Before calling on the chairman, the acting chairman, to round up the program and pray for us, I want to please tell all of you, I don't have a card. Students, can I see your hand up? I don't have a lunch ticket. Let me see your hand up. Only one. I don't have a lunch ticket. Only one. Two. You were not given a lunch ticket. Please, you have to collect your lunch ticket. Now, immediately after the prayers, don't rush. Some of the ushers will lead you to collect your food and your pack and your gift and your drink. Please, all of you with your ticket, you hand your ticket over and then you will collect your pack. So, over to you, sir, our chairman. Please, let's put our hands together as he comes forward.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I want to stand on existing protocols. So on behalf of the chairman, Dr. Makojola, once again, I want to congratulate Professor Egonmwan for the retirement. And I want to pray that she will find fulfillment in retirement. And just like the acting PC said, please find time to continue to engage the university community. At age 50, the Levites cease active work in the tabernacle. So said the Bible. So at age 70, you have exited active work. But the Levites did not leave the tabernacle entirely. They still find opportunities to be of service in the tabernacle. And so I want to enjoin Professor Egonmwan to continue to be of service to this great university. And in closing, I congratulate her and the department for this beautiful celebration. And I thank all of us for our attention and time. And I wish us safe return to our destinations. So, shall we pray? Father, we thank you for this wonderful opportunity we have to celebrate our mommy. We thank you for the grace you have given unto us this day. We pray that she will find fulfillment in her retirement in the mighty name of Jesus. We also pray that everybody that has been part of this ceremony, Lord, will visit us in our respective homes in the mighty name of Jesus. As we go home, the Lord will go with us. The Lord will bless us and be kind unto us. Thank you, mighty God, for in Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Thank you so much. The program continues with the lunch. And then we would have some of the goodwill messages also playing so that we can listen as we go on. There is also a presentation that we made by one of the old girls group. So we will also take that as we go on. And so on this note, I want to thank every one of us for coming. Yours sincerely, Dr. Iwajomo, saying do have a pleasant afternoon. So students, just hold on. You will be ushered to where you will pick your food and other items.
the field of zoology has been inspiring. Thank you for your year of guidance and expertise, and I wish you a fulfilling and enjoyable retirement. God bless you, ma'am. Bye.
I wish you happy retirement. You have touched each and every one of us in various ways. So I wish you happy retirement. I wish you good health and plenty, plenty of your heart desires.
Well, I want to congratulate you on this your retirement stage. Your contribution has gone a long way helping the zoology of department in the University of Lagos. Won't say we love you, but we have to let you go so that you have enough time to rest. Congratulations once again from the zoology of the department.
To the women who
are the ushers leading them. The ushers. Where are the ushers leading the team, the 10 of you? Come now, come. Start going. Hold on. Start coming, yeah. The next row. Oh yeah, go. Follow.
We don't want this side, like, they should wait. This side should wait. Let's do it.
The princess of zoology department, Professor Egonmwan, I want to wish you happy retirement, in good health, wellness of mind, and every goodies your heart desires from God. Happy retirement, ma.
My mama is my mother to me. She's not bad. She tried a lot for me. She's a good mother to me.
Happy retirement. God bless you.
I wish mama good luck. I wish her long life and prosperity.
My name is Jessica Mulapokoya, a classmate for Zoology Year 4. I met Prof. Egonmwan in my 300 second semester, and that was one of the most tiring time of my stay in school. But when I got speaking with her, she encouraged me, and then what she told me was what took me through that semester. I want to pray that as she's going, God will go with her. Anytime we hear from her, it will be with great news and testimonies in Jesus' name. Lord, we love you, and take care of yourself.
I was never Prof. Egonmwan when I was in year one, but I met her physically in year two, and I can remember when we were having in biology, I went to her office to see her, then she told me different options I could go into, and she really encouraged me, and I had to tell myself I must strive hard to do much more better in my academics, and I really did that semester. So this is me saying to Prof. Egonmwan, God bless you, ma'am. Thank you for all you do. I pray that you will never go down. You will go higher and higher, and all the days of your life will be filled with success and goodness. Thank you very much, ma'am.
Myself and the production team of this production, I wish to say happy birthday to Professor Iriowen. We wish you many happy birthdays of the day, and as well happy retirement. We love you. God bless you.
Ogo,
Elamo isa na bi olokun o taria e Gya dali ge ga ti aye Elamo isa o Gya dali ge ga ti aye o Elamo isa o
Ebe is bagba ne o
neta iwa manoria vele yo. Eh o neve sa egbava iwere esagba ne o ere esagba neta iwa manoria vele yo. Eh o neve sa egbava e kare magu obore ma ausale magi gbore ma iyo ba o kebe to dama no gia veneve o dama no gia veneve e ran se no tata egege wa sa sa unu no megwi kana motani yoba na oge mae wono eh kado kuselu de na mase oba na oge no nyado iyoba ge no nya uselu oba na bo egbe na pare ne yaye o kure o e wa kure age ti to go ti wa se oba mo nyado oba to pe aba me o ri e u gbori oge na nya u mogun o gbori e gane gane ma to ya na ma yu tete na u ge sa ma ki o e u gbori ri aba me o e u gbori ri e gane gane ma to ya na ma yu tete na u ge sa ma ki o e u gboriri wa ba me u gboriri e u gboriri oge na nya u mogun o u gboriri e gene gene ma do ya na ma yu tete na u ge sa ma ki o e u gboriri e jan ba o fegbe wele gbe amo ne gbe da fegbe wele gbe e bi bi kan se ma na ye gbe tai mama kana mo me je gbe wele gbe ma na gbe da fi gbe wele gbe e bi bi kan se ma na ye gbe tai mama ko ta na mo me je gbe wele gbe ma na gbe da fi gbe wele gbe wa sister e bi bi kan se ama na ye gbe ta u mama o ta na mo me je gbe wele gbe ama na gbe da se gbe wele gbe e bi bi kan se ama na ye gbe ta e do me o ta na mo me je gbe wele gbe ama na gbe da se gbe wele gbe e bi bi kan se ọmọ náà yẹ gbé ta yí màmá ó tọ́nà mo mẹ́ síwó ẹ̀dẹ̀ náà bìrì ohun ẹ̀ ọgọ́gọ́ náà sẹ́ ẹ̀ náà bìrì ohun ẹ̀ ọgọ́gọ́ náà sẹ́ ẹ̀dẹ̀ náà bìrì ohun ẹ̀ ọ̀nà ogogo náà sẹ́ ẹ̀dẹ̀ náà bìrì ohun ẹ̀ ìwẹ̀ ẹ̀dẹ̀ náà bìrì ohun ẹ̀ ọ̀nà ogogo náà sẹ́ ẹ̀dẹ̀ náà bìrì ohun ẹ̀ ìwẹ̀ ẹ̀dẹ̀ náà bìrì ohun ẹ̀ ọ̀nà sẹ́ ọ̀nà ogogo náà sẹ́ ẹ̀dẹ̀ náà bìrì ohun ẹ̀ ìwẹ̀ ẹ̀dẹ̀ náà bìrì ohun ẹ̀ ọ̀nà ogogo náà sẹ́ ẹ̀dẹ̀ náà bìrì ohun ẹ̀
Then I'll be the only way.
Ade do ire, oh, Edo wage, wage, oh.